my left we have little Joey, and on the right we have Massey. Now these are two English Shire horses. So Joey stands about 17.2 hands tall, and Massey comes in at just over 18 hands. Now they actually weigh over a ton each, and combined can pull roughly 6 tons between them. And this fully loaded probably weighs just under one. So don't worry, you're not putting any kind of strain on these animals. That is what they're bred to do. Now, just like any other Shire horse, these two are the direct descendants of the Great War Horse. Henry VIII would have had a lot of interest in selectively breeding and developing the horse into becoming the strongest and most fearless animal to see the battlefield. He wanted them to be capable to support his knights and all of their armour and swords and all into war. So as we can all imagine, they'd have had to be pretty strong and fearless to do so. And just by looking at them, we can kind of see where some of that strength really comes from. Although I don't know how fearless they are these days. Little Joey here really doesn't like umbrellas, and Massey is afraid of puddles, so they've probably lost a bit of that umbrella. As we take our trip around these front gardens, I'll point some things out for everyone, and if anyone has any questions about anything, please feel free to ask them. So we'll start off with these funny looking trees. I'm sure you would have already noticed. Now these are yew trees. And we have two styles of yew. So the ones coming down to the ground are known as the pepper pot yews. And those were planted just after the First World War, so they're coming up to 100 years old. Anyone want to take a guess at what we call the other style of yew tree?
No. I don't know.
We call them the mushroom yew trees, yes.
It's a kisses! It's a kisses tree!
Huh?
Kisses chocolate tree!
Sorry.
Yeah, that's a kisses chocolate tree. You know,
Amos. Hershey's kisses.
That's a good one, I'm up.
So those are the mushroom yews. They're actually an original feature dating back to the time of William and Mary, so they're 330 years old. Look just where the walls drop down over there.
Oh, wow.
We get a glimpse into the privy gardens. So in there would have been William and Mary's private garden, presented in that immaculate French formal style, which was very much the fashion about 300 years ago. In fact, they would have tried to incorporate the same style into all of the gardens here at Hampton Court Palace. So that is actually a recreation of the privy gardens. That was done in the 1920s. But the thing about Hampton Court Palace is it's been changed by everyone that's been here. So everyone's added or taken away their own little bits to it. But we do have a lot of things that are still in the pictures. So like the wrought iron fence work that surrounds the privy gardens is completely original just there.
Wow.
And that was all built and designed by a famous French blacksmith called Jean Tijoux. And the screens are known as the Tijoux screens, and they're being regilded back to the original state, 24 karat gold.
Yeah.
Oh,
nice. Motorway of the day, so it would have been
extremely busy, everyone going up to London. And it only would have taken King Henry 3 hours to reach central London, which is actually fast even by today's boating standards.
Oh wow. You're so tall.
Is this like a little moat?
Yes, so those trenches were dug out during the reign of Queen Anne. So they're actually all dug out as only decoration purposes. They were handy. Now they dug them out.
We're heading to the park.
Chosen wisely. You have all won the lottery of life because you have picked the best of England's queens, the greatest of all Henry's
singing
wives. No. Tower Bridge in London. In London, Tower Bridge in London. Tower Bridge in London. Wait, I'm taping. Here I am in Tower Bridge of London. Tower Bridge in London, 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 Tower Bridge in London. Tower Bridge in London, in London, in London. Did he give up, huh?
Ako, di mo naman ako pinig doon.
Yeah.